go.
Edge.
How are you, Gary?
I have an important but simple question for you. Are there days when you're waking up and you think to yourself, I wish I had never met Bono?
In all honesty, no. I don't think there are days where I would think that. I have often wondered what would have transpired if I had never met him, or in fact if we decided that maybe a better use of our Wednesday afternoons would be learning how to play snooker as opposed to music. See, the thing about this band is that we're still our mates, you know, because that's how it all started out, you know, so in that sense, there's a lot more to it than just, you know, the band itself.
But that is so obvious. I mean, having seen the two gigs at Madison Square Gardens, there's a real sense of family or friends that is communicated to the audience. Is that why it works?
U2 is a great band, and great bands are a rare thing, and I think people seeing a great band working and playing together, you know, it's a powerful thing to see. I'm not saying that we're necessarily the greatest band that have ever been, but, you know, a lot of bands, they don't like each other. They're doing it just for the cash, which is really not true of us.
And what are you doing it for, Edge?
We're pretty much unemployable in any other regard, so what would we do?
What would
we do to get out of the house, as they say?
Tell us about these guitar shops.
Well, you know, these guitar shops have been around since the 50s, and probably before there was electric guitars, they were selling,
shops are still there.
You know, acoustic guitars and mandolins and Hawaiian guitars. So they've seen every single period of rock and roll come through their door, you know.
So is this like a pilgrimage for you?
If you're a guitar player, this little strip of shops is the place that you will inevitably end up at least once or twice in your career going to, just to see what they have, you know? So we're going to go into Rudy's first. Yeah, it's kind of one of the smaller shops, but
okay.
We've always got some great stuff.
Great stuff.
This is Dallas.
I have met Dallas. Good to see you again.
Guys?
How are you?
So what have you got for us here?
It's a Jazz Master. It's a great old guitar, and it's the 60s, I think, Rudy, isn't it?
Yeah.
And
64, 65, something like that.
And it's very cheap, I believe, Rudy.
We need that Wednesday afternoon.
Oh, nice, yeah. Out of tune, Rudy. That's another $50 off.
Dallas, how many guitars has Edge got?
On the tour?
For on the tour.
34 on the tour.
Only 34.
Only 34.
It sounds like a lot.
We don't want to lose one.
No. Dallas, I wanted to ask you, do you ever get celebrities going in under the stage?
They're in bed. Christy Turlington came in.
You're blushing, Dallas.
Dallas, hold on a second.
So and when this beautiful lady, Morley, came in.
Yeah.
And,
no wonder I couldn't get your attention at that point. Very nice.
Edge, could I ask you what your favourite U2 riff is?
It was actually something I came up with whilst attempting to work on a song for the Joshua Tree album. We were shy a couple of more up-tempo songs. I went and I worked on a little four-track recording machine, and I just laid down some basic chords and a beat and started playing guitar.
Could you play it for us now?
Well,
is that it?
Well, do
it. Familiar.
Now stop. This is probably not the perfect instrument for it. the blue. Oh, that's very good.
Kind of exceptional. Yeah. It's really unique in color, and it plays very well.
Oh, that's nice.
So, you want to have a listen to it?
Yeah, let's check it out.
We should check it out. Chet Atkins. Look.
What's your favorite guitar, Edge?
I'd have to say the Explorer.
The Explorer.
Yeah, at this point.
Okay.
We've been through a lot together.
And are you using it on this tour?
Yep.
For which numbers?
For A Beautiful Day, for I Will Follow, Out of Control, New York. As riffs go, you know, some riffs are not going to really translate when played without the other members of the band. And then some riffs are just, you know,
they're going to be great anyway.
They're going to make sense anyway. So that is one of those sort of riffs.
Danny Lanois, together with Brian Eno, has worked as a producer with U2 since the mid-80s, helping to create some of the magic.
Danny, I asked you to bring me to your favourite place in New York, and you brought me to Cafe Reggio. Why is this your favourite place?